Next up, something I picked up for the personal stash. I wanted a chance. I like the little Toyota pickup trucks. I built them before. I saw this online and I picked it up. It is Aoshima RN80 Hilux custom pickup truck. It's a Toyota pickup truck from 92 to 97 body style, four-wheel drive with a lift. That's the really only way you can build this one, is jacked up as the custom truck. Now, Model Roundup is going to be sending me a stock four-door Toyota pickup truck that I'm going to be going a completely different way with. And we'll get to that video as soon as that's in stock and they send it over. But for right now, I want to build this cool custom off-roader, which we've seen a gajillion of in the United States. We'll start getting the parts out now. This is a curbside kit, but that doesn't mean that it's not worth looking at. It's not a toy, you know, it's not a junky kit. These Japanese kits are always very nice. First up, we got white mirrors on this tree. We've got the box sides, you can see, are beautifully detailed. Got the inside of the tailgate nicely done up. I'm used to, you know, very high quality from the Japanese kits, so we'll see what parts I'll be using. We got the longer box sides here, the interior, and the other side there. So obviously we're going to have some extra parts left over. We got the nice Hilux cab. The hood doesn't open. Of course, you can cut that open and drop in a V8. A lot of guys around here would drop in 305s, 350s, 283s into their Toyotas once they lifted them. Beautiful molding. Nice detail on there. We'll get out the gray parts tree. We've got three different colors of styrene in this kit. Nice front bench seat, center console, shifter there. We've got our interior pan, which extends into the front for our fenders. We've got what looks like some steering links, steering wheel. Check out the detail on that dashboard. As you can see, it is a right-hand drive on this one. Being an overseas kit, that makes perfect sense. Steering column on there, license plate frames. So that's all sharp looking. On this one, we got a bunch of black plastic trees. We got beautiful leaf springs set up. Differential with vented cover. That's a custom cover. Individual shocks and steering shock. Posable steering, it looks like, with the locators there. We got an exhaust system, drive shafts extended down for the lifted suspension. Overarched leaf springs on the back. Here we've got our complete frame assembly with engine and transmission, so you can paint this up and then hand detail that. I enjoy it. We've got our front differential. Looks like stock shocks because we're building off a stock truck, so there's going to be some stock parts in here. Looks like our tie rod for that steerable front wheels, because I see it just snaps into place. We got what looks like might be body mold. Oh, running boards. Running boards for when you build the more stock version. We've got our rear differential housing, sway bar, skid plate and suspension, front leafs, fuel tank, individual windshield wipers, and the rest of our exhaust system there. So we're definitely going to have some stuff for the parts box. We've got a transfer case. Looks like a center console, mud flaps, I'm pretty sure those are mud flaps, Hilux badges. We've got front disc and rear drums. A little fun fact, even in 2021, Tacomas in the United States still have drums in the back. Toyota hasn't changed out those differentials, they work fine. We got some repeated parts here of a steering column, drive shaft for a stock vehicle. Got our interior mirror. So yeah, that's some fun things. They keep making those differentials the way they do at Toyota. They don't see any reason to upgrade the back still to a rear disc. We've got our glass tree here. Headlights, side lights, back glass, which is a solid window, and the front glass with closed-in windows on the side. You can cut those free and just mount the front glass if you so desire. We'll get those out when we're actually working on it. We got a set of four tires with poly caps. These are super swampers, and they say so on the sidewall for you, both side, and they're real rubber. You can smell them. They're not vinyl. They're real rubber tires. They look awesome. They look the part. A little sanding and those things are going to be right on. They even squeak when you rub them in your hands. We've got three individual chrome trees, dress-up mirrors, so decide if you want body color mirrors or dressed-up mirrors with their lenses in them. We've got a gorgeous set of custom aluminum wheels or chrome steel, whatever you want to do. I'm going to make these look like aluminum, so you'll be able to see how I do that in this review. Very simple process. And then we've got our grill. We've got what looks like a fuel tank, lower bumper panel, custom grill here maybe, mirrors, small chrome parts, taillight backing, and whatnot. So that's everything that's in there. I'm going to start to build mine, and we'll be right back. This kit only took about 90 minutes to assemble, and it goes together like a very modern assembly kit. Everything lines up, it keys together, and you don't need a bunch of glue to hold it together. You don't have to fix any gaps or seams or anything. It just goes together very nice. So we'll go through the parts, and then we'll head over to the paint section when I'm done. Something I forgot to show in the beginning, they do have a small decal sheet with four license plates, two license plate frames, and very nicely a gauge package for that dashboard. And they have a mask for the glass in the windshield so that we can do that nice black outline around the outside of it like they have on the real ones. So that's included in there, and I forgot to show that. The wheels here are gorgeous. I'm going to be flat coating those and black washing them. I'll show you how I do that to get them to have the appearance of aluminum. We've got the windshield wipers. It says in the manual, if you choose to use the windshield wipers, you'll just want to go in and drill your holes in the cowl exactly where they should be. There's holes underneath the bottom. You just drill them through with a 1mm drill bit and you're all set. These black parts are the hubs to the wheels, so we'll leave those black till we're all done, and then we'll insert those and they'll look real nice in the wheels. The fuel tank, of course, will get painted separately, so I leave it on its own little tree. I don't know if I'm going to install the mud flaps or not. They are beautiful and they look like they install quite easily, so I might. Plenty of jacked up trucks have mud flaps. A lot of states are required. So I'll decide if I like that look. I'll stick them on with some rubber cement, see how I like the look for a little bit. But I'm going to get them painted up now just in case. This skid plate cross member for the transmission transfer case, I'm going to paint that up a metallic color so it contrasts with the frame a little bit. Instead of using the available chrome mirrors, they do have plastic mirrors. I want to paint them up, so I will leave them on their own little tree and we'll do the painted ones. The exhaust is the same thing. I want to paint the exhaust separate and install it. This one's got the performance exhaust with the resonator, so that's the one I'm going to use, a little bit of a larger open exhaust. We got the front rotors, the rear drums, and the rear view mirror. I'm going to get these painted, and then I'll hand paint the brakes on the front. The drums, of course, will stay black in the back. We got our main exhaust system. That's the same on both creations with our little converter in there or expansion chamber. The shocks can be inserted after the fact. These are the lifted shocks. The stock shocks are a lot smaller. These are beautiful. I want to get these custom painted and install them underneath later, so I didn't want to have to reach in with a paintbrush and paint those when I can install them separately. The bench seat, I will be painting a lighter shade than the rest of the interior, so that's on its own tree. The steering column and the dashboard, they're going to stay gray because it's a Toyota, but I will be going in and getting some paint on them and doing my own way of detailing the dashboard, as we'll see. This is how it all looks when it's pushed together. It's just sitting together. That's how well it fits and everything. So we'll start taking it apart. First, we'll let you look underneath and see that nice lift on that suspension sitting up nice and high. We'll take the body off. You can see how that sits. I've got the little holes drilled for the windshield wipers. The interior just snaps into place with those little plugs there. We'll pull it out. I've got it on its little tree here so I can get it painted. I've got the interior in. I want to paint this all a darker gray and then detail the rest of it. But we don't have any engine or anything, so we don't have to worry, but that's how that attaches. And then it's got these large mounts that will attach to the body mounts on the frame that we'll look at in a moment. The box goes together. That's the only thing that could even be considered difficult, with air quotes, and it's not difficult at all, but you can get it together. I'm going to paint right over these taillights. I can re-chrome them, and it's a lot easier than trying to build it separately and getting paint in those corners. I can always re-chrome that with a Molotow pen and then put my lenses on, and we'll be fine. But you can see the bumper delete on the back, the interior of the box, underneath. You can see the large body mounts, like it would be on the real one. and that will go down and sit. You saw it sitting beautifully on those body mounts, and that all glues together. So when you build yours, you can see how that should orient and everything, and it looks wonderful. The tailgate will operate if you want it to. Here's the frame. This thing's an absolute work of art. First up, before I forget, because this is the lifted truck, these little pegs here are actual little miniature body mount lifts. You saw them in the parts review. They're actual little 1/8 inch or a little bit bigger body mounts that will give you a nice little body lift as well. Underneath, work of art of Toyota suspension and driveline. We got the custom differential with the vented cover. We've got the extended drive shaft to get down to it. We've got the transfer case going up to the front differential. We've got the lifted suspension, and it's got posable steering, which installs so easy that I left it posable and I did not glue it in place. We got our sway bar here. It is just a lovely design, and it all keys together on that straight as an arrow frame. Every single part has a little pin. You can see even where the body mounts go, there's little pins on them. So everything goes exactly where it should and falls together, and you can see that it sits perfectly straight. You can tell that this side you rock that differential, but she sits nice and straight and there's no problems whatsoever. I'll be able to get in there and hand paint that differential cover later, and we'll get some paint on everything. I'm going to go over and start painting, and come with me.
Thank you. Thank you.
painted in detail. I continue to be impressed by my first Aoshima kit. It is just everything fits, and it's such a relaxing feeling to build a model kit where everything goes the way it should from the beginning to this point. Now, I don't know what's going to happen on final assembly, even though I've done some dry fitting, but we're going to see. And if there are any issues, of course, I will always let you know. But the lights on this kit, all the glass, the turn signals here, I just did a little bit of orange for the bulb and then put the clear lens over it. You can see where I masked that off for the plastic air dam underneath. All these parts were glass, the mirrors needed to go into place. Again, that grill, that beautiful grill and side marker light. We've got the body where the glass goes in. All the way around the rear glass, as we know, is a separate piece. Anywhere where that stuff needed to go in, it just pressed into place. The taillights just pressed into place. I used a little bit of Mod Podge to hold them so they didn't fall back out, but I didn't have to fight them. I didn't have to trim them. It just pressed into place. Final assembly, look at this chassis. Final assembly was just lining things up with its pins and a little bit of drop of super glue. The shocks went in, the exhaust went on, the fuel tank, the crossmember skid plate, the brakes on the front, the brakes on the back, the drums on the back, the shock absorbers all the way around, the steering damper, the shocks on the front. Look how they beautifully hide up underneath there. All of that just pressed into place, a little bit of super glue on the connecting pins, and you have an exquisite model. So to say I'm excited to get the one from Model Roundup, the longer wheelbase, the four-door stock version that isn't modified, I'm so excited to get that. Check out that wheel and tire package, a little bit of black wash, super swampers on there. I just ran some sandpaper over the top of the tread and along the side to make it stand out. These are real rubber tires. You can hear them squeak when you rub them together. They look awesome. They just press in. They've got long shafts here, and that just presses into those poly caps that were inside there. The interior, just a little bit of work, and check out how sweet that looks. Of course, at the end, we'll get better pictures with more lighting, but check that out. Did the two-tone grays, and then if you do a little gloss coat on there to make it look like the plastic, it actually makes the carpet look flat, because it is. And then the consoles and the dash and the door panels. The only thing lacking on this, well, the door panels are pretty much non-existent. There's really no detail inside. And I mean, I'm okay with that. You can see a little bit of an armrest, but there's no latches or anything. But otherwise, the seats look amazing with that black primer and then the light gray primer over the top. It allows those black lines to stand out. Really nice looking interior tub on there. The box looks great. You can see the taillights are in. I did the custom taillights. You could do stock taillights on this rig as well. The body's all ready to go. Did our black wash in the vents. Got to put the windshield wipers on. Got to put this little, I think it's the e-brake or something, this little pull thing on the dashboard on the inside. Might do the mud flaps. I still like the idea of them, but I'm not sure. And then I've got to decide out of my decal packages that I've saved from model kits, I've decided to put some decals on the side of the vehicle. Not sure which ones, I'm still debating, but all I'm gonna do right now is put things together. I think I can even get the interior in. Yeah, like literally while we're on camera. That's how easy this goes together. Just slides in up there, pushes in, the interior is in, no fighting. I didn't have to push, pull, yank, scream, have a fit. It just goes in and looks awesome, and it locates with those large pins onto the chassis. So I'm going to get the grill pushed on, get it all together, get those decals on, and show you that final. All right, well, it doesn't happen a lot these days, but something completely blew me away by how good it was. Now, I love every kit I build, no matter whether it's a challenge or not, but nothing about this kit was a challenge. I had no idea going in what to expect from my first kit from Aoshima or Aoshima. And I didn't know. I didn't know if it was gonna be hard. I didn't know if it was gonna be easy. I didn't know if I was gonna have a fitment issues. Are things gonna press together? Well, these things are designed just as good as any Tamiya kit out there, modern Revell, anything that you've had out. This is just I can't say enough good things. So I am super excited. I've got another kit here that is a trailer, a car hauling trailer from the same company that Model Roundup sent over. Can't wait to get that. They're going to be sending over the four-door stock version of the Hilux. So it's going to have a longer frame, different wheels, different tires, different interior. Can't wait to get to that one. And there are some sports cars that they make that obviously now I'm going to be trying to snag and build up on the channel. So make sure you look around for those. As you can see, as it goes around, it has this cool little pinstripe down the side, this little triple stripe. Well, I went digging around on my old decals and I found the stripe set from the 69 Chevy Chevelle SS from Revell that I built. I used the white stripes on that gold paint job. There were black and red stripes in the box. Well, now those black stripes have been laid down beautifully on the side of the Toyota. I had another option that I had found and cut out, and I was hemming and hawing. These are out of an AMT kit that I was thinking about putting on the truck instead of the stripe, and I decided, well, I'll save that. Maybe I'll do that on the next one or a different one that I build. The mud flaps, I couldn't decide whether I wanted to put those on or not. Well, the model decided for me, because these Super Swampers are so nice and big, the mud flaps will not hit without rubbing. So those are painted, they're not going anywhere. I can save them in case the next kit doesn't have them, and I could put them on there and I'll be able to use those parts. Of course, it is a curbside. You can see underneath, it comes out so awesome underneath there with all that detail. And at the end, I'll have pictures of the individual frame and everything for you. It's got the posable steering. It sits on all four wheels. The mirrors glue on beautifully. They just key into where they're supposed to go on the front of the winch or front of the glass, and they go in. I did leave the side glass in. I didn't cut it free. Did the paint around the windshield. You could see that came out very nice. Looks very stock on there. And everything looks wonderful. Over the top of that Tamiya light gunmetal, I put two coats of future floor polish. You've seen me apply that in dozens of other videos. The wheels look amazing with their little hubs in them. Front and rear, everything is just so, so sweet about this kit. I use the custom tail lights, the roll pan on the back, just to give it that flair of a truck that's been jacked up with a skyjacker lift or rough country, whoever he got it from, and a nice little body lift on there as well. Beautiful interior on it. This one, of course, is right-hand drive. We'll see what the other ones come with, if they have an option of both or if they're only right-hand drive. Who knows? Love how the glass goes in. I can't say enough good things about this Hilux kit from Aoshima. So I will have pictures at the end of this video. I thank you all. I want you to pick up models and build them the way you want to see them. Don't build for anyone else but you and your enjoyment. It's a hobby. It's supposed to be relaxing. Have fun with it. Don't stress it at all. You're going to have a great time, and I highly recommend this kit. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next review.